Hail, pedestrian!
Yes, what is it? What's happening? Where am I?
This is Peter Sullivan on the streets with the Monarchs Weekly. What are your thoughts on the upcoming annual AMA general election?
Election?
Yeah, the upcoming AMA general election. It's annual.
I thought the annual election was last year.
Bro, that's cringe.
Hey, Peter Sullivan here with the Monarchs Weekly. What do you think of the upcoming AMA general election? What do you think?
I don't think. I can't think. But I don't follow the Alabama Advisory News that closely. I think I won't want to graduate.
Well, you start following your student government after you graduate?
Well, isn't the Alma Mater Advisory an advisory of people who have graduated? Like, for whom Monarchs is their alma mater? Why would I care until I graduate?
No, that's not true. It's not true. It's not true. It's for current students. It's for everybody. All of us. It's for current students. It's not true. You're dumb. You're so dumb. You're my best friend. Hey! Hey, Pete Sully in the streets? Pete Fully wrecked in the sheets. What do you think of the AMA election next month?
Oh, this is a funny coincidence. I'm actually running in the next election. I'm pretty excited about it, too, because my team is going to win.
What? You're that confident of your victory?
Where the willingness is great, the difficulties cannot be great. Plus, we're running unopposed.
Yeah.
Can Team WST count on your support in the upcoming election?
Certainly.
Oh, awesome. If so, please sign here. Team WST is going to bring some real change to this campus. Oh, thank you so, so much. Oh, this means the world to us. Take care.
Yeah. Wow. Praxis at last. Never have I felt so involved in my community. Perhaps this will help alleviate my increasingly depressing and unfulfilled lifestyle. Oh, hey, I'm Petey Boy, Peter Pan, back from Japan. I'm a journalist, AMA election, what do you got?
I'm not much for politics. Whoa!
Oh, shoot, are you good?
Just kidding. I am much for comedy, though. I'm like a comedy artist. I have a show tonight and you should come see it. But anyways, politics are gay.
Is that?
Just kidding. I can say that. I'm gay. I'm gay!
Whoa. This is me and Peter Sullivan. Back to you.
Exercise this phantom in the green.
I'm in trouble, not real trouble, the kind you push aside, and inside my share beer bubble, reciting an aside, I struggle.
Story time, I find myself in line at the deli. Girl named Kelly, she wants to be a singer, no figure, her voice is also amazing. Every time she turns, they blue dress on, showing her collarbones, and when she moans, they no way to help it. You felt it in a dark studio, suspending your discretion. Time, nothing new, but I still deserve attention.
And every single ghost from past makes an appearance, first to last, handing down in the screening room. My passion's drained, I'm bleeding through with so celluloid curtain call alibis, counting down the full moon. I bow before my doom, I'll pour the phantom in the green room.
I'm hungry. Still hungry.
Oh.
Still hungry. All done. You were right. This was worth skipping my review session on discrete math.
Thanks. But I'll admit, it's pretty easy to make something more exciting than discrete math. I mean, why has it gotta be discrete? What's it trying to hide?
We went over cryptography today, so maybe it's trying to hide some big secrets.
Cryptography, scriptography. You don't need to learn that stuff. You're already an elite hacker.
Oh yeah, I forgot. Boy, everyone cleared out quick.
Well, there wasn't a lot of clearing out to do to begin with. Besides, we're all busy all the time. I'm sure they had to rush off to somewhere. But you're not busy now, which is nice. We can hang out.
I mentioned this earlier, but I can't hang out tonight. I have a hackathon meeting after this. And by after this, I mean right now. My meeting started when your show started, but supporting you felt like it was more important.
Oh, right. You're... thingy. Yeah, don't want to keep you too long, Ben. I guess everyone really is busy all the time.
True, so true. I know a lot of people wanted to come tonight but couldn't. MMT has rehearsal tonight, vinyl club is going on. There's a protest against that one guy who keeps driving on the mixed-use sidewalks and destroying the potted plants. A lot is happening right now.
How many gosh dang clubs does this school have? Jeez Louise.
It's Iris, actually.
Master comedian over here. You should have your own one-woman show.
Oh, I could never. Could you imagine? Me. On stage. Huh! I can't do that. I could never do that. Never. Never.
Nah, you should. Think about it. Think about it!
I won't.
I just can't believe there are so many clubs and not enough time to join them all. I just want to hang out with my friends. I wish I could just join all the clubs.
But you'd be spread molecule thin, which can't be good for your mental health.
Yeah, you're right. I want to stay peanut butter thick.
If only there was a way of joining every club and still maintaining a thick peanut butter texture.
Maybe one day we'll figure it out.
Buzz, 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 buzz.
Hey, Mom!
But I'm Dad, kiddo. I dropped a hammer on my phone, so I'm using your mom's phone now.
Hey, Dad! What's up?
Sorry, I can't hear you so good. I'm working outside in the shed. What are you doing right now?
I'm trying out makeup looks for the MMT show. Then I'm going to walk over to Iris's and we're going to study together.
Well, that's great to hear.
I had my own show today. That went really well.
Have you thought about what Mom said about minoring in law? And did you go to that shed crafting workshop I sent you? You know, when you were a little girl, you never wanted to build sheds with me, but I think you'd like it now that you're older.
I have thought very carefully about it, and I've decided not to minor in law. You know, it's actually an entirely different department from the arts, so I couldn't even minor in it if I wanted to. And I did go to that shed crafting workshop, and it turns out I just don't have what it takes to be a professional shed man like you, Dad. But I still have theater. And I'm good at that.
And those workshop people, they just don't know how to teach. Next time you're home, I'll show you the proper way to build a 3-story shed with heating and plumbing installed, and you'll be a complete professional right away. And Suzanne, you're better off focusing on your schoolwork and figuring out what you plan on doing for a career. You can't make a living putting on performances and charging audiences to watch them. Life doesn't work like that. Art's a hobby, Suzanne. It's not a career.
Hey, Dad, that's cool and all,
but... And I'm being serious, Suzanne. I want you to be successful and not throw away your life on a fantasy. I want you to be happy and fulfilled, but I also want you to be able to afford food, you know. You're an adult now, and with that comes adult responsibilities.
Okay. Well, that sounds
interesting. I'll definitely consider my job prospects.
Ah, that's wonderful, honey. Now, Daddy's gotta go now, okay? I gotta get back to work on this shed. Bye-bye.
Hey, I figured it out.
Hey, me too.
What?
How to bake a mini cannoli in the shape of a dolphin.
The secret is in the use of a dolphin-shaped mold.
However revolutionary that sounds, Iris, I was talking about the too many clubs and not enough time dilemma, and I was thinking, what if we congealed all the clubs into...
The big club! Jinx, you owe me illegally distinct soda pop!
Haha, nice.
But, wait, how would we even implement that? Like, you understand how truly ludicrous an idea it is.
The dream is dead.
Oh.
Wait, no, it's not. I was interviewed by a man this week about the upcoming AMA elections.
Ah, the upcoming AMA shindig.
Yes.
Yes.
So here's the thing, right? Who runs clubs?
The board of each club?
Right, but I don't mean individual clubs. I mean who runs clubs, like all the clubs.
Oh, the AMA.
Exactly. And the elections are coming up. The public contest to determine our future leaders.
Are you suggesting that we could be those future leaders?
Precisely. And if we control the clubs, we control...
The clubs?
Yes.
Holy shit.
Let's go!
Let's go!
Whoa. You good, Iris?
I thought maybe I could punch a hole in the desk. Wait. How do we run for AMA?
So you want to run in the AMA executive election, and you have come to me, Rector Hector Montgomery, the voice of the students, to help you register?
Yes. It's serious. It's seriously serious. We care about the clubs, the studies, the children, the orphans, the dolphins. I care about the dolphins.
We care about the dolphins.
Well, assuming that you are seriously serious and not just serious, there are some seriously serious things you need to seriously, seriously think about. For starters, teams run with three people. There's the president, the vice president of operations, and the vice president of university affairs. But it seems that you only have the two of you in your party.
We also have Charlotte.
Who's Charlotte?
Excuse me. Sir Rectum... Rector? Would you mind if we took a moment to privately chat?
Well, I don't see why not.
Who is Charlotte? I don't know who that is.
She doesn't exist. She's a construct from my mind. Pure fiction.
But won't that make it hard to get into office when office requires three people?
Yes, but here's what I've realized. Merging all the clubs together is too silly a platform to actually run on, so let's just see how far we can get in this real election with our fake campaign for fun.
I like fun.
Yeah, you're getting it. Like, imagine if we won for real. No. Who's gonna expect us? The look on people's faces would be priceless.
And we could add like a ton more weird stuff to our platform too. People who are jolkenlightened will vote for us. But without a third member, we won't have to worry about accidentally getting elected and having actual responsibilities. All fun and no downsides.
Here's to nothing really changing.
The rector.
Rector Hector?
Set honest goals. I will set honest goals. No more lying.
Rector?
No more lying like Dave.
Are you okay?
Dave, you dirty liar.
Are you dying?
Why'd you lie?
Rector?
You know what happens when you don't tell the truth, Dave.
Rector Hector?
Lies go right to your hips.
Rector!
And you can't afford to have anything else on those hips.
Suzzy? Iris?
Dave, I'm sorry.
Mr. Montgomery, sir?
This position meant everything to me.
Suzzy, and Suzzy, please
hope that you can forgive me.
I'm so sorry I called you Rector!
Oh, sorry, I was just practicing an acapella.
Charlotte is also running with us.
Does Charlotte have a last name?
Yes.
What is it?
Parks. She couldn't be here today because she has a cough. A very bad cough. The worst cough imaginable. The cough that ends lives. Yes. The name for it is Gunther's cough. It is a condition that is real.
That is a real shame, then. What position does Charlotte hold?
President. Operations Vice President, actually. I'm the President.
All right. Well, if Charlotte is Operations, and Suzzy is President, and I'll assume then that Iris is University Affairs?
Correct.
Kabow! All right, well, first step of the process is complete. Second step consists of getting a total of 400 signatures in order to qualify for the race.
400? That's a lot of people. Goodness, oh my. I don't think even I know that many people. And I know a lot of people, like at least 10.
Well, if that's the case, I'd be more than happy to help get you started as your first signature. Kapow!
Wow, really?
You bet. It's really good to see new faces running for the AMA. It can be really hard to break in if you aren't already cozied up with those on the inside. I didn't know anyone in the AMA at the start of my term as rector, and I had to overcome many hurdles because of that. Not just institutional and social ones, but like literal hurdles. I'm so excited to start my first day as rector. Sure hope there aren't any inconveniences in my way.
Oh, wait.
Kim, sorry, what are you doing in my home?
I'm Adelaide, AMA room bookings manager. I'm also Adelaide, soon to be AMA executive election teams validator. No big deal.
Oh. Cool. Sorry, what are you doing in my home?
I'm in charge of rooms, bookings, repairs, maintenance, logistics, distribution, the like. And now, since you're an AMA employee, I also get full access to your house and your fingerprints.
Oh. Cool. It's my first day, and I was just having some trouble getting to my office on account of all of the hurdles blocking the entrance. So if you can just help me to, you know what?
Oh. You must have me confused for one of those non-progressive types. You don't have to worry about that with me, friend. I don't see hurdles. I'm hurdle blind.
And ever since then, I have had to pick up the hurdles myself, every morning. I've talked to the AMA executives, the board of trustees, the chancellor, the dean, the principal, And every time I've been given one of three options. Either one, the hurdles don't exist. Two, the hurdles aren't a problem. Or three, the hurdles are a problem, but they're not going to do anything about it. I have worked too hard for my seat. Hopefully, this will make it easier for you to earn yours. Kapow! The deed is done.
You won't regret this, sir. You just made a great choice.
I love the enthusiasm. I assume that's all for now?
You bet. Thank you so much, Hector.
We'll be back with those signatures.
Good luck, ladies. You'll have some stiff competition.
What do you mean, competition?
What do you mean, stiff?
Good evening, class. Do I have a lecture for you today? Let me tell you. But before I tell you about the incredible comedy imbued in Aristophanes' greatest, greatest masterpiece, Frogs, we have a very special message from some very special people. So take it away, Team WST. But don't take it away for too long. Your time in my classroom is a privilege, not a right.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Benjamin Weens, and I'm running to be your AMA president.
Hi, I'm Madison Spencer, and I'm running to be your AMA vice president of operations.
And I'm Gunther Trost, running to be your AMA vice president of university affairs.
Together we form Team WST, and together we are running to be your AMA executives.
For too long, dog owners have had to deal with the issue of broken glass on the sidewalk. It's time to fix how this community addresses dog feet.
This is lame. Right, Iris? Iris?
Iris!
What?!
I spaced out completely. I was thinking about dolphins again? Sorry.
Yeah, we could beat these toads.
They're such beautiful creatures. So majestic. They make perfect arches when they leap out of the waves and crash back into the waters. Dolphins, I mean. I am indifferent towards toads.
We will battle these toads. Smash them! Also, that guy's name is Gunther.
Yeah, yeah!
Which is funny, because that's the kind of cough I said Charlotte had.
Yeah, what a funny throwaway gag! Tee-hee! I'm sure it won't affect anything down the line.
I'm gonna pass this nomination form over to you guys, and if you could sign it, that'd be great. And remember, Team WST,
we got your back!
I just realized we have to wait for the form to travel through the entire class before we can leave.
Be patient, Ben. We'll be fine.
Cheer up, Benjamin. What better place is there to be than this respected establishment of higher learning? Look at all these young, studious scholars.
Right then, class, put your hands up if you have not read Frogs.
Oh, God.
Well, how can it get any better than this? It's been one day and we're already 1/400th of the way there.
At this rate, it'll be summer by the time we earn enough signatures.
No, it won't. We'll be fine.
Should we walk into people's classes?
Well, we could do that, if we wanted to, but I feel like that would be cheating.
That sounds like a strange take.
What I mean is that we've all been in a class before where someone has given that same spiel and they pass the sheet around, and regardless of whether you want to sign it or not, you just go for whichever outcome your brain went to first. You know, it's like when the cashier asks if you want the receipt.
We have to earn our signatures.
Exactly.
You got any ideas?
No. You?
Nope.
Hmm.
Well, what do real campaigns do to get traction?
Get signatures from classes.
Besides that, they rally.
That checks out. But we don't actually have a platform other than our one jolke policy of merging all clubs together.
Then we don't make it an actual rally. We make it some miscellaneous event that happens to be run by us.
But whatever shall we do?
I don't know. You're the creative one.
Parade.
Too costly.
Face painting.
We're all adults here.
Barbecue?
It's January.
I've got it. At the pier, we should scream.
That already happened.
Drone at the pier.
What?
Like droning, like,
This sounds like a winner to me.
And we could call it something silly like, oral sex at the pier.
What did you mean by that? Pardon?
A-U-R-A-L, not O-R-A-L. Droning in perfect unison is an oral experience on par with sex.
I see.
Sex sells, Iris. I'm just following the market.
Now just to make an event page and invite people to it.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
It is complete.
All right, let's just share it to every group we know. Wow, already 40 people marked as going and 100 marked as interested. This is amazing.
Looks like it's smooth sailing from here on out.
So, it seems it's actually no sailing from here on out.
What's the point of performing if no one's around?
Well, because it's fun to do.
The whole point of this was to get signatures.
Well, we can go talk to classes later.
But I said I didn't want to do that.
It's the way everyone else is doing it. I don't see a more efficient way of doing it. Sorry if that got heated.
I'm scared of talking in front of a class.
What?
I don't like public speaking. It scares me. Yes, I get the irony in that. I'm an actor who's scared of talking to a crowd, but it's different when I'm performing. It's a controlled environment where I'm playing a character, and being myself in front of a lot of people makes me nervous.
I didn't know that. I'm sorry.
I didn't tell you, so don't worry about it.
So, I guess I'll be giving the speeches then?
It looks like it.
I'm sure you'd do fine. I'd listen to you if I didn't know who you were.
Thanks.
Buzz, 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 buzz.
Hi, Dad.
I'm not your dad, Suzanne. I'm your mother. This is my number.
Oh, hi, Mom. I just thought... How have you been?
Well, I'm okay, sweetie. But I've been worrying about you. I know you think you can step outside the class system, but you can't. People perceive your status very quickly, and people are going to treat you differently based on how they perceive you. And I love you, so I want people to treat you like someone they respect. When I was growing up, I had the opportunity to go to university and get a real prestigious job. Anything I wanted. And I made the most out of being a high-powered corporate lawyer until I chose to set it aside when I had you. But I didn't end my lucrative career and put my hard-earned wages into your education for you to not learn anything and not get a well-paying job.
Okay, well...
If you don't want to talk about it now, we can try again later. Besides, your father wants the phone back. He likes to listen to the 5:55 a.m. Shed Radio podcast while he works. Gotta go. Bye.
Hello. Oh, joy. Another one of these AMA things. It's not like I was already bored out of my mind.
I bet the one with the dyed hair is a bad and terrible person. And I bet her art is bad and terrible, too. Absolutely no redeeming quality to her at all.
Come along, old chap. We must deliver the gumdrops from the land of dreams to the town of Sleepyville. Yippity-dee!
Suzzy Reeves.
And I'm Iris Powell.
And we're running to be your AMA executives.
We'd love for you to sign our nomination form so we can make it on the ballot.
And remember,
vote RPP!
So to begin, do you have proof of payment of AMA fees?
Yep.
Oh my god. I love that you say in sync. And do you have proof of membership in a faculty society?
Yep.
Okay. And you do have a nomination form with the required 400 signatures?
You bet.
Shut up. Come on. Awesome. I should have mentioned this a bit earlier, so apologies for that, but candidates are supposed to run in teams of three, and there's only two of you here today.
Our running mate, Charlotte Parks.
Who is a real person.
That seems like a strange redundancy. Not gonna press on it any further, so just continue.
Ms. Parks was recently diagnosed with Gunther's cough and has been bedridden ever since.
Gunther's cough, you say?
That is correct.
Do you mind just giving me, 2 seconds?
I'm doing the space bar.
I'm proud of you. That's nice.
Buzz. Oh. Buzz. Buzz.
AMA employment team, we confirm them when they're hired, and we boot them when they're fired. How can we help you today?
Hey, Leonard.
It's Adelaide.
Oh, Adelaide! Gordon, Brock, Adelaide's calling. Come say hi. Adelaide, you're on speaker now.
Hi, Adelaide. Addie, how's the validating?
It's great to hear you all. And it's going well, Brock. To be honest, it's been laughable. I'm with a truly pathetic team right now. A theater girl and a computer science girl thinking they can run in the AMA executive election as if they have what it takes.
What are their names?
Oh, it's,
Suzzy Reeves and Iris Powell.
Oh, this
is rich. They've never held an AMA position before. They're just regular students.
The nerve of them.
Why even run? Why even live?
So when are you gonna veto their campaign? 1 minute from now?
30 seconds?
5 seconds? 1 second? And
then, right now?
Oh, I can assure you, it'll be quick. Unless.
Unless?
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 What if I actually confirm their campaign? What if I actually let them run?
Shocking!
Preposterous.
Unheard of.
Well, think about it.
Their inevitable defeat would discourage other non-AMA types from ever running for office. Thus, we could maintain our status quo, preserve our power.
No disruptors.
This means we can continue hiring our friends in positions of power.
Powerful friends means we can continue abusing those who work under us.
And abusing those that work under us means we can continue reaping the most powerful benefit of them all.
Using student funds for personal deliveries.
Sync up, Leonard.
Sorry.
Well, anyway, Adelaide, that's genius.
Thank you. Plus, it'll be hilarious to watch them crash and burn. They don't even have a third running mate. That reminds me, that's actually why I'm calling. Their third running mate, Charlotte,
she has, like, Gunther's cough.
Gunther's cough, you say?
I'm afraid so.
Well,
obviously it's a bad look for us if an AMA employee is infecting others.
All in favor of terminating Gunther Trost's employment? Say aye.
Aye.
The motion passes. He will be notified momentarily.
Make sure to withhold his severance pay. We don't want to encourage his kind of behavior.
Great idea, boys. As usual.
I'll see you Sunday for AMA brunch.
Bye, girl boss.
Bye, Adelaide.
I'll bring the honeydew slices.
Bye,
boys.
What the fuck was that?
Honeydew helps me concentrate on my stocks, Leonard.
That looked like it hurt.
It didn't.
And you lost your badge. You're bleeding and you have no badge. You're a disgrace.
Boy, boss, band-aids!
Give me your nephew.
I've come to my decision. Team RPP has been approved. You can run in this year's election. Best of luck! Oh my god.
We're in the big leagues now.
I can't believe this is actually happening. It's happening.
It's happening. By the time we're done, everyone is gonna know our name.
Celebrity status, here we come.
Yes, very soon. But how soon is the real question? When can we start campaigning for real?
The 21st.
So we have just under a week to prepare. We gotta cook something up by then.
What sort of stuff?
I'm talking posters, I'm talking buttons, I'm talking stickers.
True, but also all of those things cost money.
I'm no longer talking posters, I'm no longer talking buttons, I'm no longer talking stickers.
I mean, our promotional materials don't have to be that professional.
True, true, but what else are we left with though?
Something free, something shareable, something that can get the message of our meme campaign across far and wide.
Meme campaign, meme campaign, meme campaign! Of course! Let's just make a bunch of memes!
That makes a lot of sense. Let's do that!
We'll be right back.
I'm gonna get her. I'm gonna interview her. Hello, kind stranger. Please. I need an interview. I crave an interview. I crave an interview. Please speak to me. Please, I want an interview.
You stink of desperation. Pathetic. I'm glad journalism is a withering industry.
I have become upset as a result of this hostile environment. Yee! Hey, I'm Peter with the Monarchs Weekly. What do you think of the state of Monarchs memes for butterfly teens? Are you amused? Are you ashamed?
I thought all of those memes were funny. They gave me a good chuckle. At least they aren't those frickin' lost and found posts.
I hate those lost and found posts. thank you.
Bless you.
You're welcome.
Any time.
Oh, hello, sir. I'm Peter Sullivan with the Monarchs Weekly. So, Team RPP has been pulling ahead in advanced polls thanks to an expertly calibrated meme marketing campaign. Tell me, how does this image make you feel?
I'm not happy.
And I'm Peter Sullivan. Back to you.
Yeah, we got it.
Man, I just... Fuck, I haven't gotten a single good interview all day, all fucking week. All these people talk to me for 5 seconds, then they get pissed off and storm off or fucking punch me or all this
not,
fucking shit.
Fault,
Peter, okay? I do this for fun, man, right? And no one enjoys it. I don't even enjoy this anymore. I've lost the spark. I just... Fuck,
Peter,
I need a fucking
Peter.
Cigarette.
Peter, come back, Peter.
No! I'm on a fucking dart! Fuck!
Dog shit.
Hey. Hey.
You seem upset. Are you all right?
Yeah, I ran out of the darts. It's been a rough day. Hey, do you have any ciggies?
No, sorry.
Damn, I was hoping. Wait, I know you. You're Iris Powell.
Oh, yeah, I am.
I'm Peter. I'm a reporter with the Monarchs Weekly. Quite the election so far, eh? Woo!
Yeah, it's been quite an experience.
Yeah, it's great to see a team that isn't the usual AMA jack-offs running this year. We might see some real change, eh?
Oh, Suzzy and I have been running a pretty, silly campaign. It's not really meant to change anything, you know? It's mostly just a meme, I think. Not that serious.
Damn. For a second, I was hoping someone might make some improvements to the school, you know? But, you know, that's okay.
Why? What needs improving?
What needs improving? Oh, geez, where do I start? Wow.
Where do you normally start?
Depends. How long do you have? 3, 2, 1, jump! Hello, welcome to my home. This is a tur talk. It's like a Peter talk, but just the tur. It's a little bit silly. I'm going to tell you about the abridged, but complete, but it's abridged, history of Monarchs University. Are you excited? Our story begins in 1842, with the first ever racist party in North America. Allow me to check my notes. Here we have a man wearing red, black, yellow, and brown face. That man is Sir Reverend Googer Boogersnot. He decided to make an institution where people could have racist parties all the time. And thusly, Monarchs University was born. The Cocaine School of Business invites guest lecturer alumni convicted of rape and fraud. The school's water fountains have been replaced with vodka fountains. Our school was desegregated almost 5 years ago, and the school is constantly bending backwards to the whims of rich donors and their tiny boners. The AMA could fix this, but it doesn't. Big nepotistic circle jerks, so they invite all their friends over and they all circle each other's jerks. Will we ever find the solace that we deserve? Will we ever get the positive university experience that we're paying for? I don't know. I don't know. Any questions?
Hey, I have an idea.
Yes! Yes! That's awesome.
The AMA needs someone who's going to actually put the work in. Someone who will implement progressive policies that will amend for our school's past and reform our current system to allow for a better, corruption-free future. The more I think about it, the clearer it becomes. I'm already running in the election. RPP is getting to be really popular. I have all the momentum I need to be that someone. Suzzy and I will win the election. We will improve monarchs from top to bottom, and we will all—
What about Charlotte?
Sorry?
You talked about yourself and Suzzy. What about Charlotte? Charlotte Parks, your other running mate.
Oh, right. Suzzy and Charlotte and I will win and improve and all that stuff. Yeah, don't worry about it.
Okay, just seemed like an odd mission is all.
Yeah, definitely.
That's awesome. Let's move on. As you know, electoral politics is super duper duper important. But there are numerous other avenues of political involvement that we can go down. And if we wish to install a glorious communist government...
And then they fired me. Just like that, out of nowhere. I don't know why, but recently it seems as though people have been really hurtful towards me.
Oh, it's okay, Gunther. When I was younger, people would call me, like, dorky and a mega nerd because I would walk around the block walking my dog dressed as a scientist. It was hard to make the trek every day, knowing that at least one person would call out from their yard, "Madison, the mad scientist! Ha 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 ha!" But I ignored their taunts, and then I started walking my dog twice a day, and then three times, and then four, and then eventually, they gave up. I didn't let them stop me, and I won complete victory.
Wow, Madison, thank you for those kind words. I'm sure now I'll find the strength to move forward in life.
This is really pissing me off. How can they get away with this nonsense?
What are you talking about?
RPP. I'm talking about RPP.
What is this?
We have some competition now.
WSP, it's actually pretty funny though.
No, it's not. They're slandering us. They're gonna destroy our reputation.
Ben, calm down. Gunther was just fired from the AMA.
He what? Oh no. Oh no, 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 no.
I'm sorry, I just don't know why they don't like me.
Well, Gunther, you've been a bad boy. What are we gonna do about this? What are we gonna do about the other party?
We do need to eliminate the memes, yes. But Gunther's really upset right now. Can you lay off of him for a second?
Madison, can I talk to you alone, please?
What?
Look, I don't know what's going on with Gunther right now, but we have this other team to deal with. This is serious. We're not playing games anymore. We don't have a free walk into office. This other team and Gunther's bad rep could cost us our once secured victory.
What do you want to do?
I want to get rid of the memes and I want to get rid of Gunther.
Gunther's been with us since day one. We can't just fire him now. He knows our campaign inside and out, and it would take too long to find someone capable of filling the position.
We have to try. His presence means certain failure. We won't get votes.
Give him a second chance.
This is our last chance of getting into office, and I'm not going to let anyone get in the way of that. This is what's going to set us apart in the real world. We need this more than he does.
Fine. I guess it is our last chance. I just hate to see Gunther so upset.
What other choice do we have?
I don't feel comfortable continuing this conversation without him.
Okay. Gunther!
Yeah?
Come back in. We need you for a quick second.
Oh, okay. So I was doing some thinking with my brain while I was outside, and I've come to a decision. I feel as though I should step out of this race.
Oh?
Oh.
Obviously, this was not an easy decision for me to make. It was, as we say in politics, difficult.
Are you sure about this, Gunther?
Yes, Madison. As far as I know, the circumstances surrounding my firing are vague and confusing, and I genuinely don't know what I did wrong. In fact, last year I was named Employee of the Month. I'm getting off topic. I don't want to construe it in any way that could hurt you or your campaign. You're both incredibly hardworking and intelligent people, and you both deserve the success of the world, because I know you'll take that success and make it a better place for everybody. Madison, you're so kind, and I recognize your efforts even when you think other people don't. Benjamin, you're one of the hardest working people I know, and your success is inevitable. I thank you for the opportunity, as it has been extremely rewarding for me, and I wish you the best of luck in your upcoming election and campaign.
Gunther.
Don't run after me. I'll only slow you down. Sayonara, you beautiful wonders.
Another one. We have to destroy these memes.
And how do you suppose we do that?
All men have eyes, but few have the gift of penetration. We have to talk to the big man upstairs.
I don't know how helpful prayer is gonna be here.
No, not God. Higher than that. We have to talk to the admin of the Monarch Memes for Butterfly Teens.
Party Palace is always open. Let yourself in.
Hi, are you the admin for Monarch's Memes for Butterfly Teens? I ask because we need you to get rid of those RPP memes.
What's this about our PP?
The meme is blowing up your group. We need you to ban the people posting them.
Sure, I could be of assistance. Why'd you want to delete them anyway?
They're slandering our AMA campaign.
Hey, that's pretty cool. I've always wanted to be involved in AMA leadership. But being the captain of the hockey team, captain of the drinking team where we drink soft, legal beverages, of course, captain of the captain team, captain of the interracial bisexual senior on senior team, captain of the human animal testing biracial intersexual advocating for porn community organization, and, you know, being just a overall good guy and high regarded member of the community in and out of the AMA organization, I never really had time. Well, you know, maybe this election, I could swing it, but you know, it's too late now. Teams are already locked in, right? So you want some memes eliminated, right? 1, 2, 3, say less. I got you, brother. Wallahi, fam. Am I right? Yeah, sure, yeah. Well, I can do it for you. The deed is done. Can I get a round of applause, please? You're too kind. You're too kind. I like this guy.
So you're interested in student government?
I would be if the right opportunity came knocking at my door. Don't see how that was necessary, but...
Would you like to join our team?
I thought it was too late to join the race.
Benjamin, can we have a quick timeout for 1 second?
Yeah, we'll get right back to you, Julian. Don't go anywhere.
Yeah, this is my house, so... No, I won't, but... Fucking idiots.
What are you doing?
Getting a team together.
I have a sneaking suspicion that this guy is not right for us.
Madison, we can't be making our decisions off of moods and feelings. We have to stick by the facts, and the facts clearly state that we need a third candidate to run in this election, and he's popular and well-loved by all. This is a golden opportunity served to us on a silver, nay, a golden platter. He has too much clout to ignore, and that's all that matters now, clout.
When along this process did we decide that clout would be the foundation of this campaign? Did I miss that meeting or something? You may be President Benjamin, but we are a team here. We're running to improve Monarchs, remember? And this guy just seems like another AMA asshole.
Yeah, an AMA asshole that gets elected. We can't help anyone in a two-person team, okay? Clout gets votes, and votes gets us into office, and then once we're in office, we can help the students. Like the late and great Machiavelli once said, the first method to estimating a ruler's intelligence is to look at the men around him. And look at him. He's a pretty face, and he's highly gullible. We can make a puppet out of him.
It isn't too late to get Gunther back. And what's with all the Machiavelli shit? The Glengarry Glen Ross shit? Have you been reading plays?
I'm just saying that the strong survive. We need to be strong to get into office and survive. You want to do some good, get into office, survive. We'll figure out what to do with him later.
Okay, fine. But we're keeping him on a very short leash. And if he turns out to be the kind of fuck up that I assume he is, then that's on you.
Understood. An opening has just opened in our team.
Your team? That's fucking incredible. Yeah, I'm in. I'm totally down. I love filling up openings, like really filling them up. Can I be captain?
There actually are no captains, Julian.
But you could be president if you wanted to. Would that make you happy, Julian?
Oh, yeah, fuck yeah. Of course, I'm so down. Oh, shit. Hold on a second. Bro Mingo, you're fucking sick, dude. Bro, Mingo! Bro!
Yo, bro!
Yo.
Yeah.
I thought I heard someone at the door, bro.
Well, yeah.
Is that my pad thai, bro? Because if so, could you, like, bring it over here, bro? That'd be, like, such an appreciated gesture, bro.
Bro, I would if I could, dog. Like, seriously. But, like, dab me up real quick. Some important business. There was this, like, brown dude and this short blonde chick. And they were just, like, pestering me about, like, deleting some memes and shit. And the next thing I know, guess what happened?
What?
I'm running for the AMA elections.
Oh,
I know! Like, what the?
Whoa.
Yeah,
bro. That's like fucking pro, dude.
I know, bro.
You're gonna be part of the AMA?
Yeah.
Bro, I'm part of the AMA, bro.
Dog.
Dude, I'm Student Senator, Chief Electoral, AMA Pub Services Marketing Outreach Coordinator. Yeah. I don't know what I'm supposed to do, but it pays well, you dig.
I did that.
No. But yeah, bro, we'll be seeing each other like twice as much now, bro, if you win the election, bro.
Yo, if I win, bro.
Yeah, that'll be nice, you know?
So sick.
But yeah, I'll be sure to hype you up to my manager still, bro.
Would you?
Yeah, yeah. Whoever the fuck those guys are, you know?
Yeah.
Fucking bro.
Yo, you're a dog, bro. Yo. But like, for real, like, that would be sick. And like, I gotta be honest, I didn't know chicks could run in the election.
Mm.
And like, if that's the case,
yeah,
bro, there's more of these chicks in the AMA. Like, dog, like, I wouldn't mind having a sexual relationship with a coworker. Especially if I'm their boss, you know, it's a little bit more cash and then some smash, you know what I'm saying, dog?
Yeah, there's some real baddies in the AMA, bro.
Oh, bro.
I don't respect them at all.
Dog, nice.
Yeah.
Yo, for real though, I can use some fucking pad thai right now. Yeah, my dad has been just up my fucking ass all week about quitting coke and fucking pillies and shit. And like, dad, just lay off. Just let me do my shit, like, do my own thing.
Yeah, bro. I fully understand how you feel, bro. Yeah. This one time, my mom, she took all my fucking pillies, bro. She fucking ate them.
Bro,
what? Like, what is that even?
Dude, it's insane.
She was like falling down the stairs and shit.
But like, for real though, that's kind of lit. Like, you would probably live for a week, like for a fortnight,
for
you
a
know?
Like,
slay it, bro.
Hey, bro, I'm gonna let you get back to it, bro.
Oh shit, you're right. Yeah,
but if my pad thai comes, you let me know, aye, bro?
Of course, dog.
We'll soon,
of course, yo. Anyways, go team.
Yeah, let's go. Team WS. What's your last name again?
Thacker. Julian Thacker.
Hey, we don't even have to change the team name.
Cool. Rad.
Super duper.
Pooper scooper!
Team WST!
Woo!
Buzz, 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 buzz.
Hey, Mom!
No, it's me, Suzanne.
Oh, Dad. Hi. Look, I don't really have much time to chat right now.
The year was 1971.
Dad, no, I'm serious.
I just got off school and I went to your grandfather's workplace. He could barely speak English and the only job he could get was being a clerk at a grocery store. Once I arrived, I saw the most atrocious thing
happen.
Uh-huh. Look, can we pick this up a little later? After my interview?
A tall stockbroker and a muscular doctor approached my father's till. The stockbroker spit on my father's earlobe, and the doctor taunted my father, saying he deserved a horrible ear infection. My father crawled to me, and he said, Volinte sinimoi, tvoi otach polage na koljena, da mustanish na leja, which roughly translates to, I love you, my son. Your father lays on his knees for you to step on his back. Then the mayor's son walked up and just punched my dad in the back of the head as hard as he could. Pops just screamed at this kid, and the kid ran away crying. The next day, the mayor had my dad fired from the grocery store.
What does this have to do with anything?
Today, you have the choice to pursue a career that will make you successful and give you a salary that will allow you to live comfortably. I ask, for the sake of my father, your grandfather, that you choose to step on my back and choose a viable career that will feed your partner and your children, one that won't get you spit on.
I get it, okay? My career path has risks associated with it. Not everyone makes it in showbiz. Not everyone becomes a bright, shining star, yada, yada, yada. But I'm just at the beginning, and if I don't get anywhere, well, at least I tried. Dad, I have to start somewhere. I also don't have to make it big on Broadway. I can make a modest living as a cast member or doing makeup or some other crew position. Fulfillment is more important to me than financial compensation. Anyways, I literally don't have time for this. I'm about to do my first interview.
Interview? What interview?
Oh, I'm running for office in the student government here at Monarchs, and the newspaper wants to ask Iris and I a few questions regarding our campaign.
Government? Oh, that's a respectable title right there. Honey, Suzanne's running in an election.
Election? Oh, that's great to hear. Is politics something you're considering pursuing at school?
Hi, Mom. Well, it's actually more of an elaborate art piece kind of stunt thing. Like, I'm running as a jolke for fun. And also to show how this student government is kind of dumb and stuff. It's an art piece.
Wait. So you're telling me that my daughter, Suzanne Barbara Josephine Reeves, is taking time away from school and purposefully attaching her name and face to some kind of a fake campaign? Suzanne, I don't think you want to do that. No one will be able to understand what you're doing.
Your father is right, Suzanne. If everyone thinks you're strange and crazy, that could take away from your future opportunities, which are already limited. No one wants to hire a clown. Hello? Hello?
I'm not a clown.
You're going for an interview, you said? What if they slander you? Everyone's going to judge you for this, you know.
What if the public shames you in the streets for this? What if people riot because of you?
You're going to make me late. I'm hanging up now. Man, I'm nervous. Woman, I'm nervous. I didn't prepare enough for this. What angle are we going in with? Or does anyone know how these things normally go? Because I've never read any of the weekly's interviews before. My goodness, we're gonna get eaten alive. Burned to a crisp with tartar sauce on the side. Dante Alighieri envisioned 9 circles of hell in his Divine Comedy. But he was mistaken. There's a 10th circle. And it's the weekly interview.
Hi, sorry for the wait. Stay right there. I am your Monarchs Weekly journalist who interviews people, who is interviewing you now. I'm going to be asking you a series of questions in this interview. Are you too familiar with the term? A question?
Very. We're the best at questions.
I am not very good at interviewing people. I am new to this. I have not been working at the Monarch's Weekly Journalism for that long, but I want to impress everybody. My mom studied to be a journalist, but could never practice her craft. I want to make her proud of me. You hear that, Mom? I love you so much. I love you so, so much. I love you so much, Mom. Huh. The cassette stopped working. It was working earlier, so it should be working now. I am really unhappy. This is very unprofessional of me. Now I'm going to have to remember every word in this interview using my brain. I like coffee and tea sometimes. It makes me think of when my mom used to drink coffee with me. When I was a kid, not young enough, not old enough to drink coffee, she would make me kid coffee, where she'd make hot chocolate and put a little bit of coffee in it so it tasted like coffee every week. On the weekends, she'd put a little bit of whipped cream in it. That was my special treat that I looked forward to every week. She said that if I had too much sugar before school, I wouldn't be able to focus. So, do you prefer the tea nook or roasted coffee bean central?
I actually prefer the blend.
Said no one ever. That's very funny. Suzzy?
I don't drink coffee.
Original. Quite original, isn't she? Quite the perfect child. You know, you shouldn't look down on people for their vices.
No,
Sometimes, when times were tough growing up, my brothers and I would have breakfast, but my mom wouldn't be able to afford any for herself, so she'd just have coffee, maybe a cigarette. 8 hours into a 12-hour shift at the cannery, sometimes you need something to keep your hands steady. Especially if you skipped a meal or two. Very unique. Very controversial. My mother's name is Roasted Coffee Bean Central. I like that place because of it. And I can practice my interviewing skills on people. So, which food establishment is your favorite? 1AM Eats or 1AM Eats 2, the sequel to 1AM Eats?
1AM Eats. For, yeah. 1AM Eats 2, the sequel to 1AM Eats for me. I like the waffle fries there.
You girls make me giggle. You silly little goosies. Oh, you're so fun. I like to think that I'm fairly funny. I wish I could be like you girls. Funny like you girls. My Uncle Brian hates me. He says my jokes aren't good. I really like your memes. They really make me giggle. Did you see my comment on your memes? I spent like 3 or 4 times writing it. I felt like a comedy writer for a magazine or a TV show. My dad used to watch 2½ Fellas. And let me tell you, I had more than 2½ laughs while watching that one giggles. One day, I would like to be a comedy writer. So, did you see the comment?
I'm so sorry. I don't think we saw your comment yet.
Well, that's okay. I'll just pull it up right here, real nice, real quick, on my phone that my mom bought for me. Huh, I shouldn't have let her spend all that money on me. No, no, not again. She's been possessing all of your conversation topics as of lately. No, it's her birthday soon. Let's switch to another one, shall we?
Yes, let's.
Let's. Where is it? Where is the comment? I always struggle to find things. This morning, I couldn't find my interviewer's shirt, and I almost had to wear my regular student shirt.
and my interviewer pants, too. My interviewer shirt has my special interviewer pin, and I think it makes me look very attractive and confident.
The comment?
Oh, yes, the comment. Okay, yes. Oh, no, the post. I can't find it. Oh, shucks. And on my birthday. My birthday is so close to my mom's. No, not my mom's. I'm going to start talking less about my mom.
Happy birthday.
I'm having a very hard time finding this post.
Yeah, we can't find it either. I think the post is just gone.
All right. This interview is over. You need to go. And I need to call my mom. It's her birthday soon. And today is mine.
It's your birthday, the day you're born. Lots of girls, lots of boys, lots of games, lots of toys. It's your birthday, the day you're born.
So the posts have been deleted. They're gone, vanished, eradicated, incinerated. But why did they remove them?
It says for posting non-monarch squirrels.
And the other posts?
Gone too. All under various other false violations.
Well, this stinks.
I feel like a lost soul in an empty shadow, haunted by the darkness and suffering caused by the removal of our posts from the online community. Sadness envelops us.
We've got to fight back.
But I just said I feel like a lost soul in an empty shadow, haunted by the dark.
But this is important. Look at this. This here is one of the admins for Monarch's Memes for Butterfly Teens. Guess whose AMA team they're endorsing?
Who is that guy?
This fella is the admin, Julian Thacker. He must be the one who deleted our posts, since he's such a big WST fan.
Julian has an abnormally large mouth. He has an overdeveloped liver. His big, beefy muscles absorb alcohol from the blood like a sponge to be turned into raw, explosive torque.
WST! Everybody better vote! Yo, in our dark world, it's our voices that matter. Yo, the current state of politics is beyond redress, bro.
Beyond, bro.
Beyond. Yo, we gotta start. Yo, hold on one second.
Wow, Juliet. What a great party this is. I do have one question, though. Why are you throwing this party in honor of your AMA team?
Well, it all started when my dad ate my beaten shoes to show me the importance of personal responsibility. He said the taste was definitely rubbery, and with my digestion, that was a fucking struggle, bros. You know, but if you didn't do it, I wouldn't have known its value. Said it was kind of like the time he ate my bicycle tires. Yeah, anyways, yo, then that's when WST picked me up. Yo, I started, then we just started fucking campaigning, bros. We just started fucking campaigning, it was sick.
Whoopsies.
Yeah, guys, I'm actually gonna run off.
Run off? What do you mean, run off?
We have 83 more Julians to put up.
I ejected my pod. Welcome, sci-fi aliens. What's up? No.
We all agreed on this time. You said this time worked for you.
Well, you know, why don't we just, you know, pick another time and meet then later, right?
But we can't. The campaigning window is about to close, remember?
The campaign period ends on the 27th. If you campaign or promote or advertise yourselves after that date, January 27th, Team WST will be disqualified. Do you understand?
Yes.
Yes.
English man, give me a therapist, kitty. Dad, no, don't even like bicycle tires, no.
Yeah, no, I totally remember you saying that, yeah.
Julian, what do you have to do that's more important than this?
I just, you know, my life is unstable, and I'm having a mental breakdown, and I am scared. I sleep with a blanket at night, and
Julian, it's bad enough you're not taking this seriously, but please don't lie to us.
Hey, no need to get hostile. Things come up. I'm sure there's a perfectly valid reason for why Julian is leaving us.
Yeah, no, I'm gonna be real with you, Chief. Bromingo and I were actually gonna brap over to the LC to pick up some shit for the jungle juice tonight, but you guys okay that I used the campaign funds to buy it, right?
Of course we mind!
Okay, well, that wasn't as warmly received as I intended it to be.
No kidding!
All right, okay, I am sorry you feel that way. You know what, next time we go out, I will put in twice the amount of effort. You'll see. And it'll be an excellent night. But for now, I'm just gonna head out. So deuces, take it easy. Good luck with my face.
Wait, the Julians.
Hey, sorry about that, buddy.
He who wishes to be obeyed must know how to command.
Yeah, that sounds good. I'll keep that in mind. Exit's that way.
It wasn't so, fair.
Peace.
Sure. Think about it. Madison, it's all about electability, okay? Once we get elected, we're good, okay? We just take a deep breath, grit your teeth if you have to, and let's finish putting up these Julians.
And that's why I just fucking threw this party. Fucking just threw it. Just fucking sent it, bro. Fucking threw it on the fucking wall, bro. Fucking
there. Yeah, that's
awesome. Fucking bumped your fucking your cat bone. Fucking your mom.
Yo, that's
fucking up. And then she bowled.
Yeah.
If they're gonna play dirty, we're gonna play dirty. Screw the page. We gotta let the people know some other way. We can make new accounts. We can paint the town RPP. People love our memes. They want to shut us down? We give them more.
I don't know about that. That sounds aggressive.
More! And done. See, I didn't need your help anyways.
Suzz, I'm serious. You don't want to do this. Look at all the negative comments we got on the last batch of memes.
Well, it's,
I think people have gotten tired of us.
I don't care. They're wrong. I'm going to send them anyways.
I mean, aside from the fact that I don't think you should do that, you also can't do that. The campaign period ended already. If you campaign more now, then we could be disqualified from the race.
I'm sad.
I'm sad too, but we have to keep on trucking. Moving on to more of a business note, when it comes to debate time, we're going to be screwed unless we get our act together.
That'll be easy. We'll just reference the good memes and I can perform. It'll be like a live parody debate.
Well, it's a real debate, so instead of memes, we have to say real serious things in order to actually have a chance at winning.
Yeah. I totally agree.
I'm serious.
I don't want to pivot. Let's just keep driving forward and stick to the plan. We've cultivated the perfect counter strategy. We can't beat them on knowledge of the issues, so we have to use my charisma to convince them.
No, we have to pivot.
Since when do you care so much about this?
Since I realized that we have the power to make real change. But we need to get our act together in order to show that, Suzz.
I'll think about it. I can't believe people actually showed up to this event.
Okay, listen up, bells and felines. This is the big day. This is the day we've been fucking waiting for, okay? We gotta show those two chumps that look like fucking pickles and party hats that, let me tell you, they fucking showed up to the wrong fucking party. This is our party, this is our fucking domain, okay? It's a tough crowd out there, okay? So we just gotta remember to smile. That means you, little Maddie, okay? Hey, but don't smile too much, okay? Because they might think we're compensating for something. When we're smiling, make sure it's just a nice, thin, wet, and supple, just moist crescent that just graces a light ever so beautifully, okay? And when we do it, we fucking do it big. Show them what we're made of, lay it on them, okay? You guys fucking ready? You guys fucking ready? Fucking big ol' yacht, fucking hands on me, big ol' yacht, plate my mom's fucking spaghetti on my taint. Let's go. 6-9, break!
Welcome everyone to the 177th annual AMA Candidates Debate.
Actually, isn't this the 178th debate?
Well, while the school has been around for 178 years, there have only been 177 debates.
We don't talk about what happened in 1978.
Anyways, Team WST? Team RPP? Please take your seats. The debate will now commence. Order at the debate. Order.
Boys, quit it.
Thank you, presidential candidate Thacker.
Oh my goodness. It's the Monarch's memes admin. Those slimy sleazebags. They got him on board.
Team RPP, let's start with you. Please introduce yourselves.
Oh, right. Hi there, fellow students. I'd like to thank everyone for taking the time and coming out to what will be an absolutely rousing and riveting debate. Team RPP is very grateful to have the opportunity to showcase our immaculate vision of what Monarchs University could be if you voted for us. And in the presence of... and the amazing of... and in the presence of... you know? It's really good to be here. In the spirit of... the theme of fragmentation. You know, in the presence of all of you, the students have told us we have to bring the voices into the conversation.
And I'm Suzzy, by the way, and this is Iris.
Let's just save our clapping for the end, please, so we can get on with our days.
Suzzy, what the hell? I tried. I can't make this real. I've got to jolke it. It's just a big jolk. Lighten up.
Team WST, maybe we'll have better luck with you. What does your campaign seek to benefit in terms of residents' lifestyle and culture here at Monarchs?
So we...
Mr. Moderator, Gerald, right? Yo, what's up, player? Do you remember me? Yo, bro. Didn't I fuck your sister? Dude, that's fucking nutty. Yeah, man, your whole family was home for the holidays and I just fucking stuffed her like the turkey we ate for dinner that night.
Excuse me?
Bro, she was kind of hot though.
Julian?
Dude, she was a solid fucking 7, and from behind, definitely an 8.
Julian!
Yo, it's a compliment. You're beautiful, man. You got great genes. You kind of look like her.
Mr. Moderator, I believe there are more important issues at hand. How about we just continue with the debate?
Yes, I suppose we should. Thacker, warning.
Dude, I thought we're on the same team here. What about having my back for once?
I
I told you
he was a pure buffoon. I told you.
He's ruined us. He's fucked it. 15 seconds on the podium, and he's trashed our whole campaign. Machiavelli would have never let this happen to him. And you told me he was a pure buffoon. You told me.
It's all right, Benji, it's all right. Just know I was right. Never forget that.
Team RPP, what are Charlotte's main strengths and weaknesses?
Well, the first thing that comes to mind is her strength of character and her resilience regarding her Gunther's cough condition.
God bless her soul. My sister has a cough too. I think it may be Gunther's cough, in fact. Sorry, I just need a moment. It's been difficult.
Whoa, hey everyone, sorry I'm late. I purposely came in at a quiet time because I didn't want to interrupt anything. All I ask is to be informed on the election and participate in the political process, a right I hold dear to myself.
Hey, there he is! Get him!
What a pickle I currently find myself in.
To what's really important. Mental health, for instance. The students here are struggling because they aren't getting—
I'm gonna have to stop you right there. You see, Madison, we've already found the cure to mental health. Puppy.
My depression is gone. Happiness is real!
I no longer have the anxiety that's been holding me back for years. I can do anything!
I'm actually more of a cat person, so this really does nothing for me. I will continue to suffer in silence as a result of this.
That dog reminds me of my childhood pet, Rufus Rufus. I miss him. You're mine now. I shall name you Rufus Rufus 2.0.
Friends, don't you see? The canine species can only temporarily suppress the ramifications of a mental health disorder. We deserve more than Band-Aid solutions. Mr. Moderator, this is absurd.
But, doggo?
Dog? No.
I think it's about time we open this pit up to the crowd. Let's start a line. Yes. A line. Conga. You're all still sitting. That.
Boomer go boom boom. Is this thing on? What will you do to make my Monarch's campus more accessible for cars? My 1974 Lincoln Continental can barely fit on the roads here. And they keep putting potted plants on the sidewalks. So I can't drive on the mixed-use sidewalky things they have here. And there are students constantly jaywalking in front of my huge throbbing vehicle, just begging to get hit. And what's all this divesting about? I want Monarchs to reinvest, double down on oil, coal, screw going green. We need to go black. Oil, 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 oil.
Depression and anxiety are just concepts designed by flat earthers to keep the rest of us down.
That's not a question, that's a comment. How can we answer any questions if there aren't any to answer? What is even happening anymore? I've been pulling my hair out trying to figure this out.
Like WST, RPP has a serious campaign platform, and we will improve the mental health services on campus. And we are pro-globe earth, for the record.
My main campaign platform is that I'm just trying to engage people. every year we have this election and no one votes and no one cares. And usually like 5 people show up to these debates. And I'm trying to make it funny. I'm trying to do it through jolks. But I am genuinely serious that as long as we have squares like WST just phoning it in, nothing will ever change and we'll be stuck in the same cycle of apathy forever.
Did you just call me a square? I'm a circle. Circle.
You're square. Just look at you. You're exactly like the rest of them. Daddy funded, trust funded, baby funded, stocks and bonds, Wall Street looking ass, jerk off fucking hog squeezer.
Wow, this is a really entertaining event. Isn't it Rufus Doofus 2.0?
Excuse me, could we stop with the name calling? Respectful debate is the cornerstone of political interaction.
No, it's not. Let me finish. Years I've been at this school, and thankfully, I've been able to find the oasis away from all the Julians that go here. Because of this, I can sometimes forget that this school is lousy with Julians, run by Julians. It's a Julian school for kids of Julians to populate their Julian companies when they're finished. I hate telling people I go to Monarchs because I feel like I'm being judged now, even though I look like this. I have to explain why I went to a Julian school and why every year there's a new racist incident. I just happen to like limestone architecture. Is that too much to ask?
I'm just trying to do my best here, okay? I don't like school. School sucks. It sucks here, man. But I'll be out of here soon. If I win this AMA election, my dad promised me a spot at his firm. If I stay off the coke, pillies, alcohol...
Julian! Stop! Just please stop! Suzzy's right! This school is a cesspool of Julians. And it has been for 100 years. And me? I thought I could change that. I thought I could get together with the smartest, most passionate people I know. Benjamin, Gunther, and I could get together and change that. But then, Benjamin goes and trades in Gunther for this hog guy. Because it's all a popularity contest. That's all it's ever been. Ever, forever, ever, ever. That's what it was in middle school when no one picked me for dodgeball. That's what it was in high school when no one subscribed to my informational YouTube channel. And that's what it was in my grade 12 year when I lost the valedictorian race to a girl who didn't know that the mitochondria was the powerhouse of the cell. I deserve it!
RPP is also prepared to make real change too.
Team RPP has been acting in bad faith from the very start. Your president has made that much very clear. Besides, I know she's sick, but why haven't we heard a single peep out of your third candidate this far into the race?
If she is unable to get well in time, which is looking more and more likely, then we will add a new member to step in for her in her absence.
No, we won't.
Oh, my lord, let me finish. The presidential candidate has the same intention to run a serious campaign as I do. She just actually has a sense of humor.
How is what you're doing funny?
IDK, man, it's funny to take silly things seriously and serious things silly. It's amusing. It's comic.
No, it's not! Your memes are trash and everybody knows it!
Well, you're on the other team. Of course you wouldn't like them. Hell, your new presidential candidate took them down himself.
Wait.
Okay. How about we move on to the next question? Where's the structure here?
I have a question. Mr. Julian Thacker, where were you on the night of January 28th at 11:27 p.m.?
Well, I was with the boys, and we were holding a fundraiser party for the campaign as well as our drinking team. And we're going to split the proceeds 50-50. Great advertising for WST, right?
So, this post from Bromingo is from that party?
Yeah, you bet. Why, what's your point?
Oh. The campaign period.
Fuck. Mr. Moderator, presidential candidate Julian Thacker was in clear violation of campaign policy when he hosted this fundraising party after the campaign period had terminated. This puts him in a position to be disqualified from the election.
Kapow! You may not have noticed me earlier, but I've been here the whole time. Yeah, I do feel it necessary, however, to speak to this alarming allegation. Julian Thacker, you are canceled, effective immediately. I shall run a hearing to inquire into this situation. I'm leaving now. Kapow! Mic drop.
Watch the presidential debate every so often, the vice presidential debate. Sometimes we watch the elementary school debates. I love seeing how well structured they are, and I like the truth of it.
Iris, that was bonkers. You just decimated their campaign. Incredible work. Those snoozefest goobers will never win.
No thanks to you.
What?
I wanted to present, like, real issues back there, but you kept talking over me.
Well, I don't even know about politics. I was just trying to, like, perform and make it fun and funny for people.
This is reality, not one of your shows. I didn't want you to perform, and you said you wouldn't. You always get your way, and you never think about what I think or how I feel at all.
That's not true.
What do you know about me?
I'm sorry?
Where do I work?
I don't know that.
I work at the eye service. On Johnson, I've told you this previously. Remember?
Do you want to hang out right now?
No, I have work.
You have work? Where do you work?
I work here, at eye service.
Ha! I didn't think you were serious about that. It came off as a joke to me. I'm sorry, Iris.
Everything is a jolk to you, isn't it? I guess I'm a jolk too?
Iris, wait, I said I'm sorry. Fucking shit.
Yo, bros, it wasn't even that bad. Like, how was I supposed to know?
We had multiple meetings with the AMA people where they talked about the rules of campaigning. They were very explicit about when the deadline was and what happens when you violate it. You have literally no excuse!
Yo, bro, it like wasn't in bad taste though. Like, beer and politics go hand in hand. Everybody knows that. What I was trying to do was for our cause. You guys know that, right?
We could literally be disqualified, Julian. Everything we work for is on the line. We can't just buy our way back in. Your daddy can't save us now.
Yo, my daddy won't do fucking shit. He's fucking pissed right now. He says if I mess up one more time, he's gonna take my Rolls Royce and like fucking trade it in for some 2003 Honda CRV or some shit.
We'll prep for the hearing. That means that you have to change your act. No more drinking, no more drugs, no more partying. Julian, do you hear me?
But like, I can do all this shit on my own time. The AMA doesn't need to know.
Ben, can I talk to you for a minute? Julian, you can have 60 seconds of jewel time. That imbecile has been a liability since day one.
I recognize my error now, but we had to get him. We had to get the votes.
The votes won't matter if he gets us kicked off the ballot.
If you want to get rid of Julian, how do you propose we get the votes?
We could always get Gunther back.
Do you think he'd come back to us after we annihilated him?
True. You are correct.
You're not even going to believe what I'm about to say.
What are you about to say?
What if we headhunt Suzzy from RPP?
What?
I mean, who else has garnered more attention and coverage and buzz than the Suzz?
You know,
That actually makes sense. And I was sensing some weird tension coming from RPP during the debate. Maybe she's growing disillusioned with her team. Maybe she had a rift with her partner. This could be her darkest hour before this saga culminates in a fitting, satisfying resolution.
It's the perfect time to strike. Should we annihilate Julian?
Not yet. We must first secure Suzzy. We must align with Suzzy. We must become WSR.
Great. All we have to do now is...
Hey, where'd she go?
Suzzy, you suck. Your shows are terrible. You're not funny. I can't stand you. I'm judging you harshly for everything you've done.
You are a disgrace to the Reeves name. Why won't you step on your mom and dad's backs? Very ungrateful.
Can Gunther's cough be sexually transmitted? I really hope not.
Why are you running to lead the AMA anyway? To bring all the clubs together? That silly inciting incident is long ago now. Whatever comedy you've been able to pull out of this stunt has dried up. There is no more mimetic potential. What remains is something bigger. An opportunity to improve this mediocre school. Iris recognizes this. I know you recognize this based on the shenanigans WST has pulled, based on the bigotry everyone pictures when you say you go to Monarchs, and yet, inaction remains your only action. Iris is putting in more effort than you. Why? You're scared of putting yourself in front of people. You're scared of judgment. You have a golden opportunity here, but you won't do anything to fix issues that you care about because of your selfish fears. Are you going to improve the school, or are you going to inhibit it?
I take it you're Sussy.
Professor Fenton?
Call me Cecil. You're in university now. You don't have to call your teachers by their last names.
I'm in my third year, actually.
Well, you should know that then. Oh, that sounded like berating. I didn't mean to berate you. I can see you're going through a lot right now. Is there anything I can help you with? Miniature water bottle, tissue, gum, emotional support.
I think I need everything.
Well, here, take it then. Take it all. I'll prepare my emotional support monologue. Once I had a pimple in my ear, and I found it difficult to deal with. But I found that through perseverance, I was able to eradicate it. Would you like to know how I eradicated it?
No.
Well, the point is, you can solve any problem that comes your way. What are you dealing with, Suzzy? You can tell me. There is both student-teacher as well as rideshare confidentiality here.
Well, most of my problems are that I'm a huge, stupid piece of shit, and I'm really ugly, and all my friends hate me, and I'm gonna lose the election, and I can tell people are thinking shitty things about me.
That's an awful lot of information you've just thrown at me. Why do you feel you're going to lose the election?
I was never in it to win it, I guess. I just wanted to do something silly and maybe garner some fame and attention for my art. But nobody gives a shit about me or who I really am. And those that do don't like me anymore, apparently.
Whoa, hold your ponies now there, Suzzy. One pony at a time. Let's take fame. What's it like to be famous? I've always wanted to know.
I used to think that if a tree pratfalls in the forest and no one is around to laugh, then that's a pretty bad routine. But now people are watching, And they aren't even people that I know, and it's scary. I can hear them thinking these terrible things about me.
Are they saying terrible things to you, or do you just think they're thinking mean things?
Like, a bunch of people have been giving me looks on the street like they recognize me, but I don't like it.
Maybe you're misreading the situation. You can never know what people truly think of you, but I imagine that the majority of people don't care about you.
Gee, thanks.
That's not a bad thing. For instance, I remember when me and my buddy, Brick Bradshaw, overthrew the AMA in 1978. Oh, yeah, those were the days. There were Molotov cocktails, pepper spray, riot shields, CSIS, Che Guevara stuff.
Wait, that's awesome.
It wasn't really. It was horrifying, actually.
Oh, well, why haven't I heard anything about this?
And that's precisely the point. No matter how outrageous things got, people eventually forgot. That's a rhyme. I do slam poetry on Saturday evenings. You should come sometime.
I should do that. I actually perform as well. I do theater and performance art stuff. I, ate fruit for the last one. It's weird. You probably wouldn't get it.
True cowardice is denying your own weirdness and succumbing to being bland. You don't need to worry about what other people think because those who would take umbrage to you are a bunch of square, hall monitor schmucks who wish that they could do fun oddball things like you. The people who do appreciate you are either already here with you or will be with you soon enough. For example, every Saturday night I try something new. Sometimes it lands, sometimes it doesn't. But good old Brick Bradshaw is always here in the crowd egging me on. After the show, he grabs me a beer, and we go back to his place to watch a movie, and then, well, the next part of that would be inappropriate to talk about in most contexts, this current one included.
Except I'm not sure if my own best friend appreciates me right now.
What makes you say that?
I've been running our campaign really fast and loose, but she started taking the election really seriously. She realized that the school is bigoted and poorly run and the AMA is corrupt and mismanaged and everyone's depressed and broke because of all that.
Ha! Oh, what else is new? We were dealing with that back when I was a student. The People's Militia overthrew the AMA because we were protesting to allow homosexuals to smooch on campus. Things have improved since then, but there's still a lot of progress to be made.
That was very noble of you to protest. My running in this election has only been because I wanted to pull off a silly performance art stunt. I wish I had the courage to do something more substantial.
Well, nonsense. The only person more powerful than a monarch is their court jester, after all.
But I haven't even done enough satire or pulling down the emperor's pants. Most of it has been absurd memes and me acting zany.
Well, that has value, too. Politics is a very serious business, you know, and people need the levity that comedy provides.
Well, Iris doesn't care much for my jolks anymore. I forgot where she works, and she got super mad. I'm just not good at remembering things that well.
You're looking at this all wrong, Suzzy. I think it's less you being bad at remembering, and more you being bad at friendship. You not remembering where she works is indicative of a larger thing here. You legitimately need to care for your friends. You need to understand that you have broken the creed and feel remorse and try to make it better. It happens sometimes, but you have to make it right now. Oh, look, we're here already. Is this a good place to drop you off?
Yes, here's good. And I understand the need for the creed.
Well, it's been a lot of fun, Suzzy. Anytime you need a ride, feel free to reach out. And please remember to rate me 5 stars. Oh, and do say hello to your friend for me, won't you?
Thank you. I can do it. I'm going to. Bye, Professor Fenton.
Cecil.
Bye, Cecil.
See you in class, Suzzy.
Wow. Well, well, well. We thought we might find you here, at this school we all attend.
Hey, what gives?
Hey, Suzzy, there's no need to get upset. We've come to you with an offer.
A good offer.
Why bother? You've already won the race. RPP was always a jolk, and I don't want to perform politics anymore. All it's done is make me and my friends sad. I want out.
But we want you in.
What?
Join us. We'll form a mega team. Team WSR. We'll run unopposed.
But I said mean things to you earlier at the debate, which I'm sorry for saying. It was mean of me to assume I knew you. Also, I'm not a very competent politician.
But neither was Julian. Benjamin only brought him along because he got scared.
Sorry, but I'd rather have nothing to do with this.
Suzzy, wait. Julian is a huge bingus, and we don't want to work with him anymore. If you join us, we can make some real change at this school.
And if you join us, you won't even have to do any of the actual political work if you don't want to. Me and Madison can do it. We promise.
Then why don't you ask Iris to join you instead? She masterminded all the best memes.
But the fame is attached to you. You posted the memes from your account. Your name is the most recognizable out of any of us.
Okay, but if you brought Julian on board to gain clout because of a contested election, surely going back to an uncontested election means clout is useless again.
That checks out.
But who's even heard of Iris? Like, who is she? What's her deal?
She's the best, and I love her. And she's smart and cares about, like, political stuff and politics. She's literally a great leader. She leads computing clubs, like a hackathon. She organized the whole thing. And I think your policies would appeal to her a lot. Unlike me, she'd be happy to help with the actual political work once you win.
Benjamin, can we talk in private for a second? Iris, I want her. She's the one.
Agreed. We'll take the girl. How much?
I can just talk to her myself, if you want.
Yeah, that works too. Thank you for your help.
Oh, no problem.
Farewell, Suzzy!
So, how's life?
Oh, good. I've been walking around and crying. I picked up cooking. Yesterday I made lamb chops and then cried on them and threw them in the garbage.
I'm really sorry. Thanks to my rideshare driver, aka Professor Fenton, aka Cecil Fenton, I realize I haven't been a very good friend to you. I baked you this dolphin cake. It says, "I'm sorry," in icing. I understand if you don't think I deserve a slice.
At least you've thought about my love of dolphins when you made me this cake.
I thought it would be fitting. I literally listen when you say stuff and care about what you think because you are my friend. I just forget to act like it sometimes because I'm a narcissistic person. But I want to be as good a friend to you as you are to me.
I'm sorry, too.
You didn't do anything. This is my apology, not yours.
I feel like I was too harsh to you after the debate.
No, it's okay. It needed to be said.
Well, then thank you, and I forgive you, and you can have a slice of cake.
Thanks.
So, do you actually want to do AMA stuff?
Like, is it something you truly want to partake in?
Yes. This whole experience has made me realize that I want to be involved.
Then you can do it if you want. Like, be in the AMA. You have a real opportunity here.
How? RPP isn't going to win. Charlotte doesn't exist, and I know you're not interested.
No, a real opportunity that's new that you haven't heard of yet. Madison and Benjamin want Julian out, and they want you in his stead.
Since when?
Since I had a conversation with them earlier today and they literally said that they wanted you.
And you're okay with that?
I'm like more than okay with that.
I do actually think you'd be a great leader.
Well, thank you. Wow. I love you. You're the greatest friend ever.
I love you too.
What you thinking about? Wait, what are you doing?
I don't know. Let me try that again. No, sorry, no, definitely not. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know.
Iris, it's okay. Don't worry about it.
I think I just got licked, but now's not the time, you know? And, like, you're my best friend, but platonically. We're platonic friends, and I guess I just got, like, weird and confused about it. I still love you, though, but not, like...
I know what you mean. I love you, too.
So what the fuck is up, Bozos? Why'd you guys call this meeting? What? A guy can't get comfortable in his own meeting?
Julian, you're annihilated.
But my dad, I fucking need this. My career need this. My fucking dad. You guys were gonna do this from the fucking beginning, weren't you? Yeah, you sneaky little fucks, you scummy scanters, you! Yeah, you were gonna pull out the rug up from under me, huh? Make me look fucking dumb? Well, I'm not fucking dumb. You fucking dumb bitch. Why should I even be fucking listening to you? You're like, what, 4'2"? I could take you. And you! Yeah, I thought brown people were supposed to be smart. But you're fucking dumb. You're dumb as shit, dumb as a fucking rock, dumb. You know what? I'll fucking say it. Fuck that gay rector too, you know, and his fucking stupid rules. Yeah, I've seen him get pegged in the parking lot before, and it's not that I enjoyed it, but I've seen it. Fuck him right in his rectum like he does in the parking lot. And guess what? Next thing you know, he's gonna start being, you know, this all, oh, I'm not white, you know. My friend, Fred Eggshell, well, he could have been the fucking rector, but no, they didn't let him in. He's white as shit. Whitest fucking dude I know. Eats mayonnaise on toast. So fuck you guys and your fucking stupid AMA rules that you guys should be ashamed of yourselves for just not supporting white lives. Fuck you guys and your fucking tight assholes. You fucking fuck you, dicks.
Clearly, you're not taking this very well. Take as much jewel time as you need.
Yeah, but outside?
Yeah, you can fuck off now.
You know what? Fuck you guys. Come into my fucking room, my fucking palace, and tell me what to do?
This is my room.
Well, you know what? At least I still got my jewel. You guys can't fucking take that away from me. My Julie Jewel, my Pilly Pills, my Rolly Royce. My fucking Rolly Royce. No, not my Rolly. No, that's a sweet spot. Don't put it there. It's gonna, it's gonna leak oil everywhere. Fuck, this tow truck's not even nice. It's like a 6 out of 10. It can't be fucking like that. Shit.
My fucking Rolly with a fucking CRV fucking found out about the pillies, probably shit. Fuck, man.
Jackass.
Who knows? These just desserts might just do him well. Shit, maybe. Probably not.
Forget about him. More importantly, we have paperwork we need to get in order.
I'm a pedophile's drive. I'm not a fucking pedophile. I got a clean record, mostly.
This is pretty unconventional. So what you're saying is you want to combine your parties into one party and call it the WSR?
It's WSP, actually.
Kapow! I mean, that is unheard of. Kapow! I mean, such a strong, synergistic vision. Kapow! I mean, and Suzzy, you're okay with this? And you, Julian? But yeah, anyways, that team rearranging stuff I can totally do for you today. I've got a couple of forms for you to fill out, but yeah, sure. You can combine your parties. I mean, why not? I'm the rector. It's what I do. I represent the students. Kapow!
Thank you, Hector. We really appreciate it.
Good game.
I wish Gunther was here to see this.
He loves seeing politics in action.
Good game. I wonder where he is now.
Good game.
Hello?
Code White. We have a Code White. Code White in Sector C.
Who are you? What's going on?
Stop! No! No!
I'm sure he's doing just fine.
I'm back, folks. Can you believe it? This is Peter Sullivan on the streets with the very first voter who's all ready and raring to go to vote in the election. We're going to see if the WSP party will maintain the critical vote of power that it needs to gain power. Vote of confidence means to gain power. Right.
Yeah, I'm so excited. This is my first election. I made sure I did all the research, so I'm here bright and early to get my vote in.
That's awesome. You are aware that traditionally these elections are done online, right? Like in the comfort of your own home, without leaving, like on a laptop or something.
You know what? I feel cheated and upset. Democracy's a sham. Goodbye, reporter guy.
And I've been Peter Sullivan. Back to you.
Peter, it's okay.
I just keep hurting people. I don't
Peter,
know.
It's okay. Come here.
Don't touch me. Don't fucking touch me. Okay, you can do it again, but gentle. Thanks, man.
It's gonna be okay.
Thanks. It's gonna be okay.
Hi, Dad. I just wanted to say...
I'm just kidding. This is a voicemail. You fell for the oldest trick in the book. The phone book, that is. Anyway, I'm probably busy building a shed, so please leave me a message.
I guess you've gone to bed already, so call or text me when you can. I just wanted to say this before I change my mind. You and Mom... actually... Play this voicemail for her, too. I want both of you to hear this. My whole life, you've wanted the best for me. I see that, I feel it, and I thank you for it. A lot of people would love to have parents half as loving as you are. I love you both very much. But since coming to university, you've started guilt-tripping me and berating me. You want to live my life for me. You want me to do what you wanted to do, or didn't do, or felt like you couldn't do. But I'm not you. I want different things. And the things that might satisfy you won't satisfy me. I'm not interested in carpentry or trades. I'm not interested in law or business. And it isn't that I don't work hard, or that I'm soft. I'm just not good at them. They make me feel incompetent and stupid. I want to do theater because I enjoy it, and I'm good at it. That should be enough, but for you, it isn't. And that hurts because you're my parents. It hurts when you berate my interests, and it hurts when you ignore my feelings, and it hurts when I turn to you for support, but you scold me and offer the worst-case scenarios instead. You've made me constantly second-guess myself, and I'm tired of it. You've made me feel paranoid and scared of everyone, and I can't perform properly if I feel like my audience is malicious and the world is against me. I can't do that anymore. I'm not going to live my life the way you want me to, or the way you think others want me to. I'm my own person. I am Suzzy Reeves. I'm a colorful queer comet shredding my fireball echo of stardust onto the black canvas of the night. I'm a theater kid with a knack for performance and makeup. I want to make people smile. That's what I'm here for. I'm here to make other people happy. I'm gonna put on performances that will make everyone's day brighter. I will be more powerful than any monarch. And nothing will ever change that.
It's still unclear to me why we have to wait in this creepy basement when the election party that's for us is right upstairs.
AMA tradition. But don't worry, we're gonna get you all the necessary info for you to thrive in office.
Thanks.
Julian!
What the fuck is up, motherfuckers? It's your boy,
Julian!
Coming at you from the eternal pit, goddamn Julian! Well, 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 if it isn't the little penis boy in Miss Hopes and Dreams.
Wiener! Yeah. Hopes and Dreams!
Sit up! Boner boy!
Fuck you!
Let's be civil, Ben. We don't want to stoop to their level.
You mean raise yourselves to our level, cause you're short. And that's not how height works.
Everybody, listen up. Thank you. Now, Julian, I know losing your position has been a shock to most of us. I didn't think in a million years that I could replace you, but maybe it's for the best.
What? Move out of my way, you dead meme.
No.
Excuse me?
I said no. So no, I will not move. Especially for the likes of you.
Okay, someone hold my pillies. I want a fighter. I want to beat on an inferiorly built human so I can prove I am big and strong. Yo, ape noises, boys!
Through storm and sand, my ancestral path aligns. I call on the strength of my 10,000 foremothers and fathers. Grant me the power to defeat this terrible man and his evil army. I shall strike them all down in one patented Suzzy punch. Baha ma 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 mi wumbo drama trauma boil boil toil and cry. I will defeat you, big boy guy.
Switchcraft, man, I can't even handle this. Boys, bro means, yo, we gotta slow this down. Yo, we gotta go. We gotta get the fuck out of here. Oh shit, I got nothing. Oh my god. Once you finish casting that spell, something really bad's gonna happen. My dad's gonna find out that I'm a fuck. Oh shit. Guys. The votes are in. I don't see ya. Oh my gosh, the votes, they're in.
Everyone, cross your fingers.
I know we're the only team running, but I feel like we need the luck regardless.
And there it is! Congratulations to Team WSP! Your student body has chosen you to be their AMA executive team after a record-breaking high voter turnout of 10%! We did it, everyone! We did it!
Oh my goodness! We are the AMA!
The AMA!
Yeah, we did it!
You did it! I'm literally so proud of you all!
And we did it! Despite us kicking out Gunther, despite us accepting Julian, and despite every single mistake we made...
We won despite every mistake I made. I've realized now that sacrificing our ideals in the name of good isn't very ideal at all.
WSP! WSP! That's us! I'm the P. We're gonna run the AMA.
You're going to run the AMA.
Are you sure you're okay not being in on this?
No FOMO at all. Now I'll have time to do art and have a decent GPA. Promise you'll still make time for me now that you're a high-rolling politician?
You can come into my office hours anytime.
Thanks, Iris.
Of those pilgrims born to see wind-worn and out of place, peering over the stern down. Thoughts bent on the love left in their wake. Such can they live if it be their pleasure, but in high. Why not wait?
doggo on my lap, not a lap dog, more like a take a nap dog. Watching YouTube on my laptop. Thank God for ad block tabs at a low cost. Reaching my level cap, HP for the final boss. Who am I kidding? I'm better off with Let's Plays. Passing days by with KOs and OKs, and I'm still growing up and down and sideways. No white collar weekdays, my uniform is PJs. Can make a living off of choreo and ballet. Page turning pirouettes, my debts away until the day I'm stable enough to own pets in a doorway. To a humble apartment complex on Broadway. I'm funny, like really funny, and I know you know that. Surround myself with things I like, and you're around to know that. Seeking shelter and a fresh start, there's room for me in your heart. I wanna be your tenant, a Doctor Who. Can remedy your ailment from heartbreak to cold and flu. Don't wanna be a part, fine art, fine, I'll accept it. I'll take on a starving profession and manage this depression. Got no class without a lesson, time to reinflate and float away up to the falls. I've got minutes left this month to answer when adventure calls. I'm a daughter, a brother, sister, a dancer, a hella good kisser. Recording late at night, so when I rap, I whisper. My favorite color's blue, but my emotions are too. So I cheer up for the fans when I rap a dap a do. Decisive, nice enough to make decisions. Winning's tough when the cards are given. Deal out bluffs, start to blush at the brush of stage makeup. Improvised lines I make up. You know what? Dedicate your bow to the now. Anyhow, away you can. I'm the man. This has always been a part of the plan. Listen, and then you know.
And here we are with Gunther Trost, former AMA candidate, current quarantine patient. Gunther, how have your new surroundings changed your life?
Peter, you have to listen to me. You must listen. This disease is not my doing. My mind was clouded and my eyes were blind to the truth. There's more to this story.
Do tell.
This is the mark of the Schwan, the mark of purity. Like yin and yang, I was born into the balance of another element, the Schlange. The mark of venom. This mark rests on the right breast of my twin, Gunther Tufut. He is the one spreading the disease known as Gunther's cough, and I fail to recognize it because my aura is being suffocated. I've spent time here recovering. Being isolated here has allowed me to recharge my power and open my third eye, but I fear it might not be enough.
Indeed, it is not.
He has arrived.
Exceeded anything you could imagine, brother. My disease will reach bounds that were previously unknown. The greatest feast in the universe. All for me! And not a moment too soon. I've even started spreading my cough to the rest of the world.
Gunther, you have to stop him. You have to do something. There has to be a cure.
Useless! Do you really think that there's a cure that exists for my disease? Please. I am unchained now. I'm gonna have some fun before I kill you all.
Not if I destroy you first.
I won't be bested by dirt like you!
No, brother. Cough on this. Ha!
Gunther! Gunther, you did it! You won! You did it!
The cough is no more. We're all safe now. But my life force is depleting.
Gunther, you have to hold on. Please, for me, keep fighting. The strength is within you. It's literally inside your body.
I must ask one question.
Anything.
Did they win?
Who?
Benjamin and Madison. Did they win the AMA election?
Yes. Yes, they did. They took Iris Powell from RPP to make WSP. They won. They got the vote of confidence.
I always knew they would. The virtuous must always win. We shall all be healed. My form is deteriorating, but I always knew it was inevitable. We're safe now, and I feel as though I can ascend. Sayonara, you beautiful wonders.
Understand what just happened there, but I feel as if something has been unlocked within me. Despite my recent reservations, I now have what it takes to excel in the field of journalism. I have to keep moving forward for Gunther. We all have to move towards a bigger and brighter and more just future for Gunther. I've been Peter Sullivan. Back to you.
You should know, Golden Boy.